Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. In the tradition of spoof publications like The Onion, National Lampoon, and the legendary Mad Magazine, I'm going to show you how to carve a monumental-sized message, as well as a logo, into the side of an ancient pyramid. I provided this image so you can follow along. Its link is located in the video description or project files. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. I'm using American Captain Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided the link to the font as well. For this font, I'll make the size 100 points. Make it smooth, center alignment, and black for the color. Click on the pyramid and type out your text. To adjust the space or kerning between the characters, click between those characters and press and hold Alt or Option as you press the left or right arrow key on your keyboard. To adjust the space between lines of text, go to Window and Character. This opens the character panel. Double-click on the large T in the Layers panel to highlight all the text, and drag the leading icon to the right or left. If you want to increase the size of a word or a line, highlight it and slide the size icon to the right. We can close the character panel now. Next, we're going to place the text in perspective. First, go to Layer, Rasterize, and Type. We could use the vanishing point filter, but for this particular project, I find that the transform tool is faster. To open the transform, press Ctrl or Command T. Drag your text over so the bottom line is centered over the side of the pyramid. We're going to move each corner of the transform to match the perspective of the pyramid. To do this, go to the bottom left corner and press and hold Ctrl or Command as you drag the corner to the left. Go to the lower right corner, continue to press and hold Ctrl or Command, and drag this corner until the bottom line of the transform is parallel to the line of stone on the pyramid. Go to the top right corner and drag it to the right. Drag the top left corner also to a position parallel to the perspective of the pyramid. Continue to finesse the position and angles of the transform. To accept it, press Enter or Return. Next, we'll displace it and then recess it into the stones. To displace the text, we need to make the pyramid into a displacement map. First, click the thumbnail of the background to make it active, and click the icon at the upper right. Click Duplicate Layer. Click New, and type in Displacement. Then click OK. Since displacement maps work best when they're blurred, go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 2 pixels and click OK. Go to File and Save As. Save it to your desktop as a PSD file and click Save. If you see this panel, click OK. Then click the small X on the Displacement tab to close the file. Make your text layer active and go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. Displace the horizontal and vertical scales 7 pixels, stretch to fit, and repeat edge pixels. Then click OK. Click the displacement document in the desktop and click Open. Instantly, your text's shape conforms to the displacement map of the pyramid. Reduce its opacity to 60%. Make a copy of the text by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Reduce its fill to 0%. Reducing its fill makes the text layer invisible, however, it'll keep visible all the effects that will add to it. Double-click the thumbnail of the copy to open its layer style window. Click Inner Shadow. Make the distance 7 pixels, and the size 3 pixels. then click OK. Next, we'll carve a logo into the stones. Hide the text layers and open a black and white logo or graphic. We need to cut it out from its white background. One of the quickest ways is to go to Select and Color Range. Click Shadows and click OK. This makes a selection of just the black shapes. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the black shapes to its own layer. To place the logo onto the pyramid document, press V to open your Move tool and drag the image onto the tab of your pyramid. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the image and then release. Open your Transform tool and repeat the same steps as you did for your text to align the transform to the perspective of the pyramid. To correct exaggerated distortions, go to the bottom middle anchor point and drag it up. Continue to finesse the logo's size and angles. When you're done, press Enter or Return to accept it. Since the last filter that we used was the Displace filter, press Ctrl or Command F to displace the logo. Pressing Ctrl or Command F automatically repeats the last filter. Just like we did for the text, reduce the logo's opacity to 60%, make a copy of the layer, and reduce its fill to 0. Go to Effects and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of the inner shadow effect next to the logo copy. If your logo or graphic consists of black areas that surround open areas like in this example, I'll show you how to brighten those open areas to make your logo pop more. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of the logo to make a selection of its shape. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Press Q to make the selection into a quick mask. Make sure your foreground color is black. Open your Paint Bucket tool and make sure Contiguous is checked. Click anywhere outside the Quick Mask to fill in the empty area that surrounds it. Press Q again to revert it back into a selection. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Press the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the empty layer. Click the empty layer to make it active. We'll fill it with a light sandy color. Click the foreground color and type in DEAC89, then click OK. The foreground color is now the color we typed in. To fill the empty layer with this color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. The layer mask is masking out everything but the inside areas of the logo. Change its blend mode to Overlay and reduce its opacity to 40%. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.